Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Mimi. So in this video, we're going to talk about the amount of hair care product that we are supposed to use. So have you ever thought about it, like the amount of hair care product that you are using? Is it less for your hair or is it too much for your hair? So in this video, we will talk all about that, and I'm gonna touch on the basic hair care products that most of us use, like shampoo, conditioner, hair mask and hair serum. But if you want me to talk about anything else, any other products other than this, definitely give this video a thumbs up and let me know in the comments down below. So yeah, let's begin the video. So let's begin with shampoo. So shampoo is a thing that we tend to overuse all the time, because we take out shampoo and apply it on our hair over and over again until it gives us that smooth, creamy textured lather that we are used to see in the TV commercials, that has made us believe that until you get that like smooth, creamy lather out of your shampoo, your hair won't look that good that they show in the TV commercials, which is completely wrong. Because first thing, if you use that much product on your hair, it is super stripping on your hair, and it would leave your hair dry and dehydrated, which is not something we want. So what I would suggest you guys is to dilute your shampoo first and then use it on your hair. Like, take a container or a bottle. I would leave the link to my how to wash your hair properly video on top of this video, so you can go there and see it for yourself. Take your shampoo like in a bottle or in a container and fill the bottle halfway with water. Shake it so the shampoo gets diluted, and then apply it on your hair and see the result. Like, you won't trust me, but try it for yourselves to know. Like, take half of the amount of shampoo that you regularly use on your hair, mix it with water and then apply it on your hair. It will do the same exact thing that using only shampoo does to your hair, and that way the shampoo would be less stripping on your hair and you will save a lot of product and your shampoo will last longer. And if we control the amount of shampoo we use, conditioner is something that all of us overuse. You have done it, I have done it, let's admit it. So now you would ask me, then what is the correct amount of conditioner to use on our hair? I would say that it varies according to your hair. It varies according to your hair length and hair thickness. Like, if you have really long but thin hair, a moderate amount of conditioner would do the job for you. But if you have short but really thick hair, then you would need a little bit more amount of product, because with a conditioner, your goal is to cover your entire hair length and also to spread the conditioner on each and every hair strand. But I would suggest you to minimize your conditioner wastage is to monitor how much product you are applying on your hair. Like, right after you wash your hair with your shampoo, take about a 10 rupee coin size amount of conditioner on your palm, spread it between your palms and start applying it on your hair. And here, something else I would like to add is that we are super impatient when it comes to applying conditioner or some hair mask on our hair. Like, as soon as we are done washing our hair with a shampoo, we take out the conditioner, massage it, and within 1 to 2 minutes we wash it away. The total product is wasted that way. So to get all of the benefit out of the product, as soon as you are done with your shampoo, squeeze all of the water out of your hair, because if there is excess water in your hair, it would dilute the conditioner or the hair mask that you are applying next. So first squeeze out all of the excess water. Your hair shouldn't be dripping. And then take out the conditioner and start applying it on your hair from like your neck and below. Gently but slowly apply it on your hair strands, and then take some more product and apply it on the ends of your hair. In this way, you can actually see how much product you are using, and as you are taking the time, you are evenly spreading the product along your hair length and your hair strands. And I know I suggest you guys not to use a comb while your hair is wet, but if you have like naturally curly but really dehydrated and dry hair, then you may consider using a wide tooth wooden comb in your shower. Like right after you are done applying your conditioner, take a wide tooth wooden comb, not a plastic comb, and you can slowly but gently comb throughout the ends of your hair and then work your way up. It would make sure that the conditioner is evenly spread throughout all of the hair strands. And while doing this, keep an eye on your hair if you are having a hair fall or not, because this problem isn't like same for all of us. Some people have hair fall if they brush their hair while their hair is wet, and some people don't. So if you don't have any hair fall while brushing your hair when it is wet, then you can definitely give it a try. Next is hair mask. Now if you are using a DIY hair mask, the amount you need would be a little more, because with a DIY hair mask you can also apply it on your scalp and the top part of your hair as well. But if you are using a store-bought hair mask, the amount should be same as your conditioner. And finally is hair serum. A lot of people like to use hair serum on their hair as it adds shine and nourishment to the hair. If you are someone like that, here are a few things that you need to consider before buying a hair serum for your hair. So the first thing is that the consistency of your hair serum should be lightweight. It shouldn't be heavy, because heavyweight hair serum can weigh down your hair and it will take away the volume of your hair, and also it can cause buildup on your hair. Now lightweight serums can also cause buildup. I will talk about it in a minute. Next thing that you need to consider is to look into the ingredient list of your hair serum, and it would be best if your hair serum contains nourishing oils like argan oil, almond oil, olive oil, things like this, because these oils are really nourishing. And as we apply the hair serum on the ends and throughout the lengths of our hair, these oils can really penetrate into our hair and nourish them from within. And the third thing is your hair serum should be paraben and mineral oil free, because these things can cause real buildup on our hair. Now there are high-end and drugstore serums, both kind of serums available in the market, and many of the drugstore serums contain like paraben and mineral oil. If you are using a serum like that, or if you are comfortable using a drugstore serum, you can totally continue using it. You don't have to stop using it and go and buy a high-end serum like or something like that. But if your hair serum contains like parabens or mineral oils or anything like that, it would be best if you can minimize the usage. Like, don't use it regularly, use it like once or twice a week. That would be more than enough. And if you want to look into a good serum which is like paraben mineral oil free, I would leave some links in the description down below so you can check them out. And when you are using a lightweight hair serum on your hair, you just need a little amount of product, like the amount of a Cadbury gems, that much, the size of a Cadbury gems, that much serum would be enough for the ends and the lengths of your hair. If you are someone who has naturally dry or naturally curly hair, I would suggest rather than using a hair serum, use a leave-in conditioner, because right after the hair wash, as soon as your hair gets dry, it loses the maximum amount of moisture. So using a leave-in conditioner will give back or return the moisture to your hair. And once your hair is hydrated again, and once it has got the hydration back, it would naturally look healthier and shinier than dry and dehydrated hair. So that's it for this video. I hope now you know how much products you need on your hair. And the products which I mentioned, some of my favorite shampoo, conditioner, hair mask, serum and leave-in conditioners, I would leave in the description box down below. So definitely open it if you want to check them out. And also give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. And I'll talk to you guys later in my next video. Bye.